The video you're about to watch was developed as a job aid to help you, the NWS rep, perform complex or infrequently performed tasks. This job aid was not meant to replace any directives, maintenance, or modification notes, or any other documented procedures. If there is a conflict between this job aid and any official documents, the documents will take precedent.
Technical proficiency in the field is critical to NWS staff being able to establish or relocate a cooperative observing site and maintain that equipment properly to guarantee data quality. This video will step through the process of installing an 8-inch standard rain gauge. Policy and procedures related to the SRG can be found in NWS Manual 10-13-15, Cooperative Station Observations, Appendix A. This job aid will help you gain an understanding or provide you with refamiliarization of the following: equipment components, rain gauge stand assembly, rain gauge site installation best practices.
Hi, we're here to talk about the 8-inch standard rain gauge, the cornerstone of the co-op program. When you place an order to NLSC, you'll find it under the hydrology section, Section D in the Engineering Handbook 1. The part number for the entire setup is D040. Individual components of the gauge are listed as a subset of D040. And when you get the gauge and it arrives at your station, you'll get the overflow can, the funnel, and the measuring tube. Okay, we've seen what you get from NLSC when you place an order. When you're out in the field, you may find several different types of overflow cans, measuring tubes, and funnels. Here we have the original brass overflow can. This one looks rather dull and weathered, and that's okay because you have a nice polished up brass overflow can, and it might be worth something to somebody and they may steal it. In this case, you have a brass overflow can, but somebody's painted it, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It kind of disguises the value of the gauge. Here we have an aluminum measuring tube, which was part of the original issuance for the gauges back years ago. There's many still in use out in the field. And the same with the brass measuring tube here. And then up here up front, brass funnel. And any of these combinations can work together. Some fit together better with others, but they all work and they're all valid. And one other thing with the funnel, you'll also notice that there are two screws 180 degrees out of each other. Along the lip of the overflow can, you'll see the screw holes. And you can put screws in here and you can see the notch that's in the funnel. What you would do here is, particularly if you're in a windy area, is that you'll be able to, the observer will be able to slip the funnel down and lock it so that in the event of a strong wind, this funnel is not going to blow off. Sometimes it depends on your observer if it'll cause more problems than it will alleviate. Well, one other thing I want to point out is when you get the stand from NLSC, it's going to come with these pot aluminum nuts and bolts. You may want to consider swapping these out for stainless steel. These aluminum bolts have a tendency to shear very easily and also rust. At least with stainless steel, you have a better chance of this lasting a heck of a lot longer. One thing that comes up is how you put the spikes onto the frame. As you look down here onto the frame, you'll see that these have the wings out. Now, there's a lot of people who put them in that way because it's easier to make adjustments when you want to re-level the gauge. If you'll take a hammer and you need to re-level it, you have a nice easy surface here to hit. Or in some cases, you can even take your foot and step on it a little bit to help re-level the gauge. Well, that makes it convenient for you, but that same area, surface area that makes it to hit or step on is also a safety hazard. This we show as an example of what not to do. We're outside here at the training center at the instrument plot, and this is what the standard rain gauge stand looks like. As you can see, you have the three frame parts. It has the three spikes that connect down to the lower section, see by the two bolts on each of the legs. And then you have the two holding rings. You have the upper ring and the bottom ring that has the base plate in it that holds the gauge. Well, when you're ready to sink the gauge, you can see that on this particular one, the spikes are probably about 15 inches long. And as you can see from the dirt marks in here, we only had to take it down about a foot below the surface. There are other spikes that you may find on these gauges that can be 2 foot long. All you need to know is that you just need to sink these deep enough to stabilize the gauge. It may be a foot, it may be a foot and a half. Now there's different methods that you can use to dig your holes. One is by using a digging bar, which is a solid 5 foot iron bar that's pointed on one end and has a small shovel shape on the other end, and you just pound down into the ground to loosen everything up and you can sink your spikes in. The other, as the picture shows, is if you have a heavy duty drill that you can attach a large auger bit that's about 3 inches in diameter, and you can use that to drill holes, and that's very effective when you're in dirt and sand. If you're in a rocky area, not so much. Otherwise, there's post hole diggers, shovels, the standard equipment. If you're putting this in a lawn area or even a hard packed dirt, you might get the observer's garden hose and soak the area for about 5 minutes, soften it up. And then just take your hammer and pound the stakes into the ground. That's a quick and easy method too. Now that we have our gauge set in the ground, we're gonna wanna make sure that it's level. And you're just gonna take a standard level and look across, and then you're gonna make adjustments to the legs, either raising one side or lowering another side so that it's level, not just one way like this, but you also need to look at it this way because you're dealing with three legs. So you may need to look at several angles to make sure that it's all level. Once it is, then you're good to put the gauge in. Now that we have the stand set and ready and level for the gauge, we're going to go ahead and put the gauge in. In goes the measuring tube, and then the funnel. In a sense, the gauge is ready to go. However, we're going to check one more thing. Is one more time, we're going to go through and check to see if the gauge is level. Your 8-inch rain gauge is now ready for use.
Having completed this video job aid on the 8-inch standard rain gauge, you should now be familiar with the equipment and the assembly procedures. Again, official policy and maintenance procedures can be found in the NWS Manual 101315, Appendix A. Siting standards for precipitation gauges can be found in NWS 101302, Section 3.2.